Once the first seller profile action is pending publishing to Advantage, the vendor can begin the second and final part of the catalog first steps process, creating and publishing the baseline products action. The overall steps and workflow for this baseline action are extremely similar to the following additional action types: add products and change products. However, the baseline products action is a one-time action that cannot be repeated. Additionally, once the baseline action is published, all active temporary price reductions, or TPRs, will be canceled and will have to be reestablished. In order to create the FCP baseline products action, the vendor first needs to create a baseline modification in EMOD, as indicated here by this message, stating that there are no applicable EMOD IDs associated with this contract for this action type. Navigating to the contract in EMOD, we will create a new modification for us to link to our catalog action. The FCP baseline product action can only be linked to the modification type catalog baseline commercial off-the-shelf or COTS products. Selecting that here will create the modification for us to link to our FCP action. Our catalog baseline modification is now created with an ID ending in EA2. As a vendor at this point, I can navigate to FCP by first navigating to the upload documents section of the modification, and then within the documents table, where the price proposal template is referenced, I can press the Go to FCP button. FCP then opens in a new browser tab. If you are not already logged into FCP, you'll be prompted to enter your login credentials, which are your FAS ID credentials. Navigating back to our catalog, the first step section indicates we are ready to begin step two. I will press the Create New Catalog Action button next to step two, which takes us to the Create New Action page. Clicking the baseline products action type expands more information below, including instructional information specific to the action type, a field to link our EMOD ID, and a question specific to the products I intend to include in my action type. Clicking the drop-down menu provides all EMOD IDs applicable to our action type for this contract. Here, I will select the modification we created earlier, ending in EA2. Next, I will select a response for whether the products listed in this catalog action will be sold on GSA Advantage. If selecting some or none, I would be prompted in the next screen to upload a price proposal template file for submission to the CSCO for review. See the Catalogs with Mixed Composition training module for more information regarding these options. Here, I will select the All Products Will Be Sold on Advantage option to take us through the product file submission and review process. Pressing the Continue button creates the baseline action, along with an ID specific to FCP, allowing us to re-access this action from the catalog overview page if we were to navigate away. In the right-hand side of the screen, we see our contextual informational panels are now updated to include our action status, our ID, our linked EMOD ID, and where our products are intended to be sold. And in the blue panels below, we see instructions for how to edit our product file for our baseline action and information regarding the overall process, along with the currently approved catalog file. In the main portion of the page, we see various sections listed that are specific to the actions workflow. Each section must be completed in succession. The first step of our workflow for this baseline action is for the vendor to upload a product file or multiple product files for validation. All vendors should start this process by downloading the currently approved product file for this contract and opening the file in Microsoft Excel. The FCP baseline product file reflects products and prices currently awarded under your MAS contract. Vendors will need to enter data into the following fields during the baseline products action, as these will all initially be empty. The recycled content percent field is required only for copy paper offering products. The most favored customer name and price fields are required only if the vendor does not participate in transactional data reporting or TDR. The government price no fee field is required for all products, and the value must be computed off of the government price with fee value. Review cell notes on the product file for the computation formula. The dealer cost, most favored customer markup percentage, and government markup percentage fields are required if using markup-based pricing. Additionally, vendors should check the photos fields. If photo file names are missing, ensure new photo file names are listed. Double-check the full list of products and delete products where needed. For information vendors cannot change during the baseline action, vendors cannot add TPR information, as all TPR information will be ignored once the baseline product action is published. Cannot add products that have not been already awarded on the contract. Cannot change the government price with fee field. Vendors should add photo file references for any additional photo files that will be provided, or update previously provided photo file names if different photo files will be provided. Additionally, the information submitted shall be reflective of the prices currently awarded on the contract. Once ready, the vendor should save the product file in Excel. In the Upload Product File section, the vendor can either click and drag files for upload or click the link to Choose From Folder, which opens a window that allows the user to select a file from their hard drive. After selecting and adding a file, press the Upload button to stage the file in the Uploaded Products File section, where the user can go through and add more files if needed, or remove any files that may have been inadvertently uploaded. Vendors can organize their catalogs into multiple product files for ease of upload and maintenance. Pressing the Submit Product Files button kicks off the automated validation process. See the product file and the error remediation process training module for more information regarding the automated validation process. As validation checks are performed, the action status will update automatically. If a user role is not specified in the action status label, then this means no action is needed by the user and the system will automatically progress through its processing in the background. Refreshing the page, the action status is updated to pending validation and C&P results, meaning that the product files are now submitted to FCP's backend database, where they will undergo validation against business rules. If any product files fail business rule validation upon resubmission, then an error report will be generated for the vendor to review and take action on. If the product files pass business rule validation, then the system will work to generate a compliance and pricing report containing market research for the products listed. This process can take several hours, and once complete, the vendor receives an email notification indicating the action is ready for next steps. Once the market research process is complete and a compliance and pricing report generated, the action status updates to C&P report available pending vendor upload, and the vendor can now download and review the file. See the Compliance and Pricing Report training module for more information regarding the report and what is returned. During the baseline products action, the vendor must address any compliance flags, but should not address any pricing flags. If you wish to reduce your pricing, submit a price reduction modification, either temporary or permanent, after the baseline is published. Items omitted from your baseline product file due to non-compliance issues will be considered deleted from your contract. Once the vendor is done modifying the compliance and pricing report, the vendor uploads the file or multiple files back to FCP for submission. After submitting the file, the system runs through the same validation checks as before and will return error reports to the user for remediation as needed. Once all product files pass validation, FCP automatically submits the product files to EMOD, as indicated by the sending to EMOD action status. EMOD has a file size limit of 100 megabytes, so if the file exceeds this size, the system will automatically split the file to fit within the file limit. Once a submission to EMOD is complete, our action status updates to requires vendor action, vendor must submit to CSCO and EMOD. No further action is needed by the vendor in FCP at this time. Now, after navigating back to EMOD as our vendor and to our contract that is linked to this FCP action, I will press the Edit Mod button to open this modification for review and submission. In the Upload Documents section, we now see the product file submitted by the vendor in FCP in the Price Proposal Template row. If multiple product files were submitted, then multiple files will display here. The vendor edits the modification as needed in EMOD, ultimately submitting the modification to the CSCO. Once the vendor submits the modification, we can navigate back to the action in FCP. And we can see that the status is now updated to pending CSCO review. I am now logged into FCP as our generic CSCO user account. And from our catalog overview page, I can see the list of actions currently under GSA review. I will click into the baseline action. And this page now shows the compliance and pricing report submitted by the vendor, along with the final workflow section for capturing CSCO determination. At this point, the CSCO can either intend to approve, which progresses the workflow along for the CSCO to then approve and sign in FSS Online to ultimately publish to GSA Advantage, or intend to request clarifications, which indicates the CSCO will unlock the modification in FSS Online to send the action back to the vendor to make edits and resubmit back to the CSCO for re-review, or can intend to reject, which indicates the CSCO will reject the modification in FSS Online, which will then automatically update the FCP action status to rejected and ends the workflow. In the case of rejection, the vendor would need to initiate a new baseline products action in FCP. Additionally, for any determination path, the CSCO can input a comment, which will be saved to the action and sent to the vendor. Comments will be helpful in the case of clarifications or rejections so that the vendor can better understand the reasoning for the determination. For our training demonstration today, I will select intend to approve for this catalog action and submit. Pressing the submit determination button, the action updates to read only and the status now displays as require CSCO action, complete mod in FSS Online. At this point, no further actions are needed in FCP, and I will switch over to the FSS Online desktop application where we will submit the final approval and signatures for this modification. In FSS Online, after the CSCO navigates to the modification, they can perform their review and process the modification through to the approval state, as was indicated in FCP. After the FSS Online approval process is complete, then the modification is marked for approval and is ready for vendor e-signature in eMod. Navigating back to eMod as our vendor, in the signed modification section, I will press the sign package button to step through the DocuSign process. Once the DocuSign process is complete, the modification will be ready for CO e-signature back in FSS Online. Navigating back to FSS Online as our CO, I will act on behalf of the CO and complete the DocuSign process. Once the DocuSign process is complete in FSS Online, the modification is considered complete. Navigating back to FCP as our vendor, I can now see the action status is pending publishing on Advantage. In the background, the system is submitting our baseline action through to GSA Advantage for publishing, which can take several days to complete depending on the size of the catalog. Once the baseline product's action is successfully published to Advantage, the vendor receives an email notification indicating the action is published. The FCP action status updates to published on Advantage, seen here in the closed catalog actions list. The currently approved catalog file automatically regenerates with the product information included in the approved baseline product's action. And the catalog first steps process is considered complete. At this point, the vendor can proceed with creating additional FCP actions to update the catalog as needed, to establish sales, add new products, change product information, etc.